Hey, Good Fox here. Today I got a review of Rickey Jackson's Boss Battle Left Outside Linebacker card. Now, 225K for... Wow, I don't know. I don't know how to say this. This is maybe my favorite left outside linebacker of the whole year. This guy I like better than Anthony Barr. Let's go through the stats first as I talk through that. So, 88 speed, 93 strength, don't matter. 99 tackling, 97 play rec, 97 block shed, 99 power move on my squad, 93 finesse move. I got the motivators on him, and then read and react. Get that. I got it up to tier 2. If you get it up to tier 3, he's got 91 zone coverage. I think actually maybe I do have tier 3. But then the motivators get to 99, 95. So basically, this is a left outside linebacker that can do it all. Maybe the 88 speed's a little bit slower than Barr, but 6'3 is a little shorter, so not as great of a user as Barr. But basically, if you're going to leave him in coverage or if you're going to have him pass rush, he can do it for you and do it very well. I like the ability to be flexible for my players because I don't just sit in one coverage. I have my guys do a lot of different things. I ask them to do many things from blitz to drop into coverage, drop to the sidelines, drop to hook zones to man up. I don't really man up that often, especially with linebackers on the field, because I just think it's generally a bad idea to man up linebackers because you're going to get roasted. But I will switch to like a speed package or a dime package if I do that. But Rickey Jackson dominating his side of the field, 6'3", high enough to sky and get that. So the 85 jump, you know, isn't too terrible. It's not obviously great. He's not gonna, you know, get you too glitchy of picks like say a 6'6" Floyd would, or a Shaz with his better jumping, but he's a little shorter. Anyways, so the 91 zone coverage on the card means you can drop back to coverage and he'll get those glitchy, you know, off the screen picks that he'll go anywhere. He'll react instantly to the ball. But then the block shed at 97, you can motivate that up to 99 with Von Miller, but that means you got to start. That means Jackson has to be your backup left outside linebacker, which isn't a big deal because his chemistry, secure tackler, should be on many other players on your squad. And that's really, I mean, what changes this card from good to absolutely phenomenal, in my opinion. Not only the price not being too terribly, because this card should be like a 500,000 coin card, but the secure tackler takes his 200,000 coin card, makes him basically the best left outside linebacker in the game for a 4-3 scheme. 3-4, I think I still might take a Mac because of the under pressure chem, if he's going to rush the whole time. But Mac can't drop in coverage as well, so this one's probably a little bit more valuable. Basically, with my Mac, I start him at left outside linebacker, and I sub in Jackson and put Mac at defensive end in my scheme. So that's how I approach it. It's kind of like a luxury more than anything to have him. But I think if you want a solid defense, this guy can get out there, make some plays against the toss, against the dive in the middle, against the pass. This is one of the foundations of my defense. This is him coming from the other side of the field to make that tackle. Nice little pursuit on that one. Up the middle, like, yeah, sure, he still get blocked a lot by, as you see him shed that block, blocked a lot by, like, guys with good angles on him, the tosses he might not get out to there as well, because just Madden mechanics. But, you know, that's a complaint for every card. And this one not being a million coins, basically, you don't have to invest as much into him to get him. So I love the way this card plays, not too terribly priced. So out of 10, I'm going to give him a 9.8. Thanks for watching. Call to action. I'll see you tomorrow.